Shivdat is a shy person, but extremely talented.
He receives everything in whole, wholesale, and then decides what to keep, what not to keep.
So, to be able to translate a very modern material, a modern vocabulary into a religious building, that too of Punjab, not a generic Indian building, that is a very big achievement, which we don't realize.
He worked his way up from basically a draftsman who studied at the Delhi Polytechnic and worked so hard and so diligently that he was noticed by Le Corbusier and Pierre Jenneret, and he worked closely with them, actually learning his architecture by doing from the masters.
And I think it's interesting to see, just to put in parallel, this space, and I would consider it an urban ensemble rather than just an individual building, with the scale of green space around it, is actually extremely successful in a way that I think the capital is not.
Being a student of modernism, he took the tenets that he had learned in his formative years and had applied a vernacular and relevant touch to all his designs. By doing so, he was able to make his projects look like they belong in the setting they were built in.
Where we had the cafeteria at one level, the guest house was on the upper floor. He used the circular forms with the ramp going up. It's a very interesting building and a very sculptures building.
This was one of the most prolific periods of Sharma's career. Working as chief architect of ISRO was an exciting opportunity to explore and design major campuses in different parts of the country.
And what beautiful projects he has done. Not at all like what people in Chandigarh were doing. I'm not saying that they're wrong or whatnot, but it's not a style. I think he created, while in Bangalore, his own style, his own work, his own search. And I think that is what really has impressed me most.